The squishy physics of gels are everywhere in our lives, in our bodies, in our homes, and even in our food. For years, it was assumed that once a gel forms, it never changes. But then why do gels toughen over time, or sometimes collapse entirely? To answer questions like these, my group has developed detailed computational models that let us peer deep inside the gel. We'll return to that soon, but first, some background. Before a gel becomes a gel, it starts out as a complex fluid, a mixture containing microscopic particles known as colloids that are suspended in a liquid. Like a drop of food dye, colloids in a liquid will spread to explore the space around them. This random motion of the individual particles arises from collisions with the molecules of the surrounding fluid. This is known as Brownian motion. Other microscopic forces affect them too. Some forces cause particles to attract, while other forces cause particles to repel. We place them on a spectrum, ranging from strongly attractive to strongly repulsive. Crowding matters also. We quantify this by the particle's volume fraction, or how much space the particles take up in the surrounding fluid. Together, these parameters locate a colloidal suspension in a phase, much the way water can form a solid, liquid, or gas. When the fluid is densely packed with particles, the colloids struggle to move, like a person stuck in a crowded room. Since they cannot move freely, the colloids essentially freeze into a crystalline structure. In contrast, colloids at lower volume fraction can wiggle more freely, as atoms do in a liquid or gas. Colloids can also transition between these phases through the process of phase separation. Just as water vapor can condense into a droplet, colloids can condense together, leaving the surrounding fluid void of particles. But this phase separation can get interrupted. Attractive forces hinder the colloids as they phase separate, bonding them together into a network and thereby creating a gel. We often refer to these gels as an example of arrested phase separation. Using our simulations with nearly a million particles, we can peer inside the gel and study exactly how it evolves. Here, as the gel ages, we see strands of particles getting thicker and fluid pores opening up. This process is known as coarsening, but to really understand what's happening, we need to look closer. Deep within the strand, particles are jammed together and unable to move easily. Things definitely look arrested here. The surface of the strand is covered with particles that are more mobile. Although these particles have bonds with several neighbors, Brownian motion gives them the extra kick they need to break free and migrate along the strand. But how do they know where to go? The curvature of a strand creates an energy landscape that's determined by the number of bonds a particle shares with its neighbors. A particle with few contacts has more energy than a particle with more neighbors. Particles with fewer bonds will migrate to tighter bends in the strand where they can gain more neighbors and reduce their free energy. As many particles migrate, the strands smooth out and the energy landscape flattens. Without the lure of gaining more bonds, particles tend to stay put. Our work shows that this age coarsening is very slow phase separation, and, paradoxically, it is self-limiting. The driving force for phase separation is the curvy network that flattens out and leaves thick, ropey strands. The outermost particles on the surface of the strands hold another clue. Here, we see particles diffusing into the fluid and rejoining other strands. We discovered this is actually a process of evaporation and condensation, which suggests that phase separation is still ongoing. By tracking these surface populations, we made another surprising discovery. As the gel ages over time, the relative ratio of these four special surface populations stays the same. The fixed ratio between populations is a stoichiometric balance. It's a hint that an equilibrium-like process is still pushing the gel to phase separate. But the overall population of condensing and evaporating particles shrinks because as they acquire more bonds, the particles sink down into the strand and get trapped. This is how gels coarsen. So the coarsening process in an aging gel consists of three stages. Highly mobile particles condense onto the strand, where they diffuse along the surface to gain contacts and reduce energy, thereby smoothing the energy landscape. Eventually, those particles gain enough contacts that they're frozen inside the strand. The aging process of a gel shows that it's still attempting to phase separate, but in doing so, has deepened its own arrest. Is it possible to release this arrest? In the next video, we'll explore that question by looking at how gels behave under shear forces.